Today's SportsSwigger tutorial is entitled Exfiltrating Sensitive Data via Server-Side Prototype Pollution. To solve the lab, we must pollute the object prototype and trigger a remote execution command to exfiltrate the contents of a secret file in Carlos's home directory. Access the lab and log in with the provided credentials. Winner Peter. The lab functionality is similar to the previous one. Click the Submit button to update your billing and delivery address, then go to the admin panel page and run the maintenance jobs to clean up the database and file system. Now go to Burp Proxy HTTP history and look for the requests you've just made. Post my account change address and post admin jobs. Send both of these requests to Repeater by pressing Ctrl-R. In Repeater, we are first going to confirm that prototype pollution is possible. When we change our address and billing information, the new data is sent to the server as JSON. The server also responds with a JSON object that appears to represent our user. This object has been updated to reflect the new provided information. If the server is using a vulnerable merge operation to add the new address to the user object, we might be able to pollute the object prototype. We can confirm this by using the server-side prototype pollution extension. If you don't have the extension installed, go to Extensions, BApp Store, search for the extension and click Install to install it. Now, to use the extension, right-click in the Request panel and select Extensions, Server-Side Prototype Pollution Scanner, Server-Side Prototype Pollution, Body Scan. Click OK. If you are using Burp Professional, the extension will report the prototype pollution source it found in the Issues panel on the Target tab. If you are using the Community Edition, go back to Extensions Installed, select the Server-Side Prototype Pollution extension and monitor the Output tab for reported issues. The extension has confirmed that prototype pollution is possible via JSON status code and JSON spacing. Next, we know that the server is using Node.js and we have this functionality for running maintenance jobs. This is a classic example of the kind of functionality that can spawn Node child processes. There are a number of potential command execution syncs in Node which occur in the child process module, such as spawn, exec, and exec file. For a good payload example, we are going to use this page from Hacktrix again, but this time let's try the next example using environment variables and CMD line. Copy the payload and add it to the change address request. We are going to change this argv0 property to require child process.xxsync. Now instead of the touch command, let's send the curl command to the collaborator server. If you don't have Burp Professional, you will not have access to Burp Collaborator. The Academy's firewall blocks interactions between the labs and arbitrary external systems, so you won't be able to use your own server or any other service here. I will include a link in the description for a free trial of Burp Professional. Send a modified request. Our injected properties get reflected. Now run the cleanup jobs. This should spawn a new child process that will hopefully get polluted with our injected properties. To check that this worked, go to Collaborator. When we click Poll Now, nothing happens. If we go back to Hacktrix, we can see this DNS interaction example. It also adds a shell node property to Proto. Let's try it for ourselves. Send a request and run the maintenance jobs. We get a nice error message. It seems that the server tried running an octl dump command, but wasn't able because of our shell change. We can also see the version of Node being run. Now, when we go to Collaborator again, we can indeed see some DNS interactions. We have RCE. Now to exfiltrate some data. We can do this by adding a command as a subdomain to the Collaborator URL. Let's start with who am I. Make sure to use thick characters, not single quotes. Send the two requests and check the Collaborator interactions again. We can see that the user is Carlos. We can also do list files. We see that there is a secret file in the current directory. Now we just need to cat the contents of this file. Cat secret. We have our secret. Copy it, go to the browser, click the Submit Solution button and paste the exfiltrated string. The lab is solved. As a side note, we are lucky that the first file in the folder was the one containing the secret. In order to exfiltrate all of the files, we would use a payload like the one in the lab solution. This command lists all of the files in /home/Carlos, takes this list and converts it to base64, and then sends it as the body of an HTTP post request to our collaborator server. Now we can just take this encoded string, paste it in the decoder, and select decode as base64. It seems that the directory contains two files. This is it for today's tutorial. See you in the next one. Bye!